So earlier this week, Steel Wool Studios finally dropped an update for Five Nights at Freddy's security breach. This update brought many much-needed things to the game, including things like adding a save point that can be used in the end section of the game, various quality of life improvements, improved textures, as well as, of course, a whole bunch of bug fixes. But despite many of the changes being positive, some aren't as awesome, especially in terms of unused content, so I just wanted to make a quick video detailing what's still kicking around and what isn't. Anyways, with all that said, smash like if you love to see some crazy file size reduction. Let's see how this almost 10GB update affects the unused content here in Security Breach. Well, long story short here, a very large chunk of the unused content that was once left over in Security Breach has unfortunately been gutted from the game. And this was especially seen in the unused map side of things, which was a pretty big chunk that I covered in previous videos. I spent some time going through the files again, and it was honestly really sad to see some of these really cool things get obliterated. These removed maps include the Character Gallery, the Chica's Feeding Frenzy minigame, the early Bowling Alley test map along with the bowling minigame that was found inside of it, the early version of El Chips and the East Arcade where the two rooms were directly connected instead of having a hallway separating them. Although the utility southeast corner is still in the game, it actually removed the connecting go-kart storage area that was presumably supposed to connect Rockstar Row to Roxy's Raceway. Main Lobby Master, where we could see the outside area fully modeled with collision, was taken out. And lastly, the entire backstage map that contained the removed backstage area, as well as the VIP kitchen and party room, was removed as well. I guess on the bright side, some unused areas are still left over in the game, including the Hive Arcade Room, this unused utility corridor that was supposed to connect the daycare to Monty Golf, this room with all of the vats of Fazgoo, and thankfully the full version of the golf minigame with the 9 otherwise unused holes is still left intact as well. Although it's not definitive, seeing the unused maps removed from the game is pretty disheartening to me, as it suggests that maybe the developers are truly abandoning some of these rooms instead of working to add them to the game in a future update. Sure, stuff like Chica's Feeding Frenzy and the Character Gallery were in a pretty unfinished state for sure, and yeah, there is a chance that these might get added back into the game in the future, but I don't know, I just have a bad feeling about these removals here. I guess these maps were probably taking up a lot of storage space, so removing them certainly makes sense to save on space, but yeah, I just thought it was really cool to see these left over as they gave us an awesome insight into the game's development, so I'm pretty bummed to see them removed. But I guess the developers really needed to make room for textures that take up 174 megabytes. Thankfully, things are much better in the other categories of unused content that I've covered. Both the magician as well as the unused stylized comedy bots are still kicking around, as are the textures for the unused alien and mime bot variants, and the frozen endo is still here too. One graphic thing that I did notice was removed is the Hour 7 main menu background video that featured the underground pizzeria, which I thought was kind of odd given that we can actually save at the end of the game now. Also, thankfully, the leftover menu with the extras option still intact that I went over in a previous video can also still be accessed, though it appears that the text on the main menu has been, like, squished together. Anyways, the options on the extras menu are still here, but of course, since some of the things that they used to lead to have been removed, they either no longer work, or like in the case of the character gallery option here, they just cause the game to restart. The DLC button still doesn't do anything here, and despite a whole bunch of the other stuff being removed, surprisingly, the scrapped survival mode option here still works. In fact, it works a little bit better because you no longer have to access the debug menu to unlock movement, as when you spawn now, you can just move right off the bat. Otherwise, I played around with it for a bit, and it doesn't really seem like anything else was changed within it yet, so it's still pretty broken, and I still wasn't able to actually open any presents to progress in the mode. Anyways, back to more things that were changed. For whatever reason, the name Cassidy for the princess in the Princess Quest minigames has been changed back to just Princess. This makes me think that either maybe the developers revealed a bit more than they should have with this name, or that giving the name Cassidy to the princess was a mistake. But since they went out of their way to change what's otherwise a pretty minute detail that most players of the game would never see, I have a suspicion that maybe the name Cassidy must have been a pretty big deal though. The removal of the name here also sets back various theories I've seen online for this game, so sorry game theorists, I guess it's back to the drawing board for this one. Now, although a bunch of previously unused content was removed, on the flip side, some new text strings have apparently been added, and these appear to reference areas that are currently not found in the game, or game plot points that don't exist. There's reference to a small electrical room that controls power for the kitchen, a freezer room that's apparently different than the one here, as this one is said to contain a large supply of good old Chef Boyardee. Not sure if they actually got the licensing to use the Chef Boyardee name, but honestly, who knows? And then there's also text referencing emergency shutoff valves for the trash compactor. Now obviously, if you've played through the game, you know you do end up using the trash compactor to, compact some trash, but no such emergency shutoff valves are ever used in the game. And lastly is a pretty funny text string that has one of the developers, wanting to expedite the deletion of some file. I think this one speaks for itself pretty well. Some of the other strings here, like door here, electrical box, and fence gate locked, we've seen in some unused maps as floating text, so I wonder if this text is found somewhere too. I'll definitely have to look around some more and see if I can find it. Anyways, basically the opposite of what I said earlier about the maps being removed, it's cool to see that these are added in as it gives me hope that we could see new areas and objectives added to the game at some point in the future. Now those are most of the major changes on the unused and hidden content side of things, but what about the speedrun exploits I also covered in previous videos? Well, from at least the major ones that I've covered, the Kami clip that could be used to deload most of the map when jumping into Freddy has been seemingly completely patched, as it seems the game no longer lets you enter Freddy while mid-air. And I tried to do the trick to jump up this corner in the room near the start of the game to glitch out of bounds, but I just couldn't get it to work at all, so I'm assuming this was patched out as well. Surprisingly though, one major glitch that still does work is the one where you can go up the side of these stairs to jump up on this concession stand, to then jump on top of the elevator here to deload most of the area to skip into Phaser Blast without needing a party pass. So yeah, I guess at least we got this one. So it seems like if you want to exploit cool glitches to be able to beat the game in under 5 minutes, unfortunately you're gonna have to find a way to keep playing previous versions of this game. This is only the first major patch to the game, and although the game still has some loading issues between areas, and several chunks of unused content were removed, for those that aren't unused content fiends like I am, this update is certainly an improvement. Sure, loading is still pretty janky, but lighting seems to be improved, and Shattered Monty actually works in the West Arcade now. That said, a big part of why I really enjoyed playing, speedrunning, and coming back to this game was because of the jankiness, the speedrun exploits, as well as the cool bits of leftover unused content. And if I didn't make it clear already, I really hope the other unused content still does make it back into the game someday. Anyways, yeah, just wanted to give you guys a quick update, so thanks for sticking around and listening to me whine about the removal of unused stuff that, for most people, was just taking up hard drive space. Check out my previous Lost Bits videos on this game if you haven't already for more context, subscribe to find your way back in the future, and as always, I will see you in a bit!